So welcome to the new episode of Thoughts for Education. Today we have Dr. Kajal Sharma, who is HOD Health Sciences, Vidya Jyoti University. Welcome to Thoughts on Education, ma'am.
Thank you so much for inviting me. So this is Dr. Kajal Sharma, PhD in Microbiology, basic specialization in clinical microbiology and biotechnology fields. Here I am to give queries and answers about various questions we came across in education and education sector.
Yes, ma'am. So firstly, I would like to ask you, what are the key factors that have keep you connected to the education sector?
So I can say with my experience till now, I am having 3 to 4 year experience in teaching. The teaching, the teachers and the teaching method is one of the basic element in education sector. How we are, the methodology we are adopting to teach the teachers, that content we are giving to the teachers, how we are guiding the students for their betterment in their upcoming futures, in their foreseeable futures, what are the various attainments they are going to have in their future. So these are the basic key factors and the effect of key factors in education system.
Yeah, that's a very great insight, ma'am. Secondly, I would like to ask you, what are your thoughts on leadership?
Okay, according to me, leadership is like a teamwork for me. We should always carry our whole team as together for the betterment of the organization, for the college or any kind of institutes. One should not have a bossy attitude for the betterment of the team, for the betterment of the individual or for the organization. We should carry all the team members and we should treat them equally, and that's all.
Yeah, that's great, ma'am. So next question from my side would be, the education system in India and in foreign countries is very different. How do you think that your institute provides best curriculum to the students?
Okay, so in context of our institution, our organization, we basically follow the practical theorem, right? We provide the basic skills to the students that have the applications in students' basic life. In health sciences sector also, we give the practical knowledge about the various subjects like microbiology, how to collect the blood samples, how to treat the patients, how to console the patients during their treatment. Okay, these are all the things in my department, in the health sciences department.
That's great, ma'am. Next question from my side would be, what do you think are your institute's greatest strengths?
Can you repeat the question?
Yeah, exactly, ma'am. What do you feel are your institute's greatest strengths?
Okay, so our institute's greatest strength is the quality of the teacher and the location of the institute. In near and dear organization we have the best quality of teachers from the best institution. So the teachers and teaching method will be better, and the students will be able to understand well. So, and the content and the curriculum we are following from the PTU, Punjab Technical University, as our institute is affiliated from PTU, and the curriculum we are following is the best among the rest.
That's great, ma'am. The next question from my side would be, what do you think are your roles and responsibilities towards the students and towards the university?
Okay, so for the betterment of the student, we should particularly segregate the students according to their thinking level, according to their grasping level. And we should treat each and every student individually, and we should give the knowledge according to the student level.
I would like to ask you the next question. What do you feel your institute does to welcome students of different ethnic backgrounds and economic backgrounds?
Okay, we can financially help them. We can financially give an opportunity, financial wise, we can give the opportunity to the students.
Any suggestions you would like to give to the aspiring students and youth?
Okay, so for this question, I can answer that be focused, have aspirations, have big dreams in your life that you can achieve. Only when you have big dreams in your life, various aspirations, then only you can achieve them. Otherwise, without aspirations, without dreams, and without any kind of inspiration in your life, one cannot achieve success. So this is my main mantra in the life, and I can give this mantra to student as well.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. That's all from my side. Thank you for being part of this interview.
Thank you. Thank you so much.